Timothy Mason.
Ooh! Okay, okay. Right. Happy Pathfinder Day, people. Woo. And for the people who didn't have a girl or any kids to celebrate, happy Beater Day. And and for the people who waste tissue that day or a sock, that one sock that you like, damn, I can't find another pair too, let me use it. Y'all are deadbeats because y'all just killed y'all kids. So happy deadbeat day to me too, because I'm a bad deadbeat for a lot of millions of sperm. So this day, I called my dad. Yes, I do have a dad. I'm not an unknown disappointment, people. I'm a known disappointment. So my parents know I'm a disappointment to them. And I would talk to my dad, and he was like, so when are you going to have kids? And I'm like, that kids. I don't know about it. Because at this point in my life, people, I know my kids are going to be little thoughts. I just know. You know how women get pregnant, they listen to Beethoven and classical music? My ball sack is full of kids that listen to nothing but porn. By now, they know every porn I have watched. And the last thing I don't want in life is me being able to look my little daughter, and she's like, oh, say mama, say mama. She's like, Mila Khalifa. I'm like, and now my wife mad at me, like, how she know that name? I'm like, wait, let's do it again. Okay, let's do it again. Say mama, and she's like, Amber Rose. I'm like, damn, you just fucking me over today, aren't you, little bruh? And I just know it because my kid's going to be twerking and everything. They're just going to be bad little ass porn stars. I don't know what to say about it, but it will happen. I'm not happy about it, but I don't know what you want to do with your kids. Like, is it too late to put classical music on them? Like, when they, but then they're going to be smart thoughts. They're going to be rational about it. They're going to run, like, organizations, escort organizations and shit. I'm like, damn, I raise smart little thoughts these days. But that's just one thing me and my dad talk about. The other one, he was just wondering, are you still doing comedy? And I'm like, yeah. And it was just a disappointment in his face when I told him that. I haven't heard disappointment like that since I told my dad I was going to college to be an art major. And he just, that was not a good talk. I'm like, Dad, I'm going to school. He's like, you are? Yes. You're like, what, you gonna be a doctor? I'm like, And like a dentist? You're like, what, you gonna learn to fly a plane? Maybe. You're like, what you major in? Art. I'm like, art? What you gonna do with art? I'm gonna use it for comedy, Dad. I'm gonna just have an art degree. And I'm gonna be one up on these comedians. Now when they go up to the stand-up, they're gonna be like, well, I don't got an art degree. But I still let my dad down because now I'm a community college dropout. And that is not a good feeling to be a community college dropout. At least Kanye, when he dropped out, it was a university. That's like effort right there. Well, at least you got into a university. Most people don't get in. But community college, that's just like anybody can get in. You just got your GED, you wondering, huh, what can I do? Community college. It's like the prostitutes of school, pretty much. Like, anybody's welcome. Oprah Winfrey just give it out. Like, community college. And you don't even got to pay for community college. As long as you broke, people. If you broke, financial aid is the way to go. If you're, I don't know how to say it, but if you make a little too much money, financial aid will whoop the shit out of you. They don't give you shit for anything if you need it. Like, your parents make $50,000 but a single mom. That's still a lot for financial aid. Like, I don't know what financial aid needs, but they need to give out more money because they only pay for your books and your classes, and then you spend the rest of your life in community college eating ramen noodles. And it's not even fun in community college, people. When you're in community college, you're pretty much just at your lowest point in life. You just left high school. You don't know what to do with yourself. You're like, oh, man, what am I going to do in life? Because that's where it's the melting pot of what you're going to do in life. You go in there with dreams. I'm going to be a nurse. And then you leave with a general study degree. That's how it goes, people. General study all the way around. Because nobody leaves college with good grades and morals. But now that me and my dad talked that out, You know, he's a little happy for me. He like, oh, how you like Colorado? I'm like, it's cheerful up here. Because I'm from San Antonio. He asked how the weather. I'm like, it's good. Because he's like, oh, in San Antonio, it's like 102 degrees right now. I'm like, oh, hell nah. But the weather in Colorado is tricky. Because it was saying like 71 degrees. And you're like, oh, man, that sounds beautiful. But when you go outside, it don't feel like 71 degrees. It feels like the sun have been watching black people get beat for 400 years, and now you want to beat on people. He just like, man, I look pretty fun. I might have to give it a shot. That's something you whooping on niggas ass these days. People, I don't know what to do with it, but that son got a whip, a lip, and he don't take no shit. My name's Timothy Mason. Y'all have a good day. Woo!
Give it up for Timothy Mason one more time. Woo! All right, we're going to bring up our Nylon Vigil.